In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet, Special Right Triangles. Our directions are to find the missing side lengths and leave our answers as radicals in simplest form. In this video, I'm going to do numbers 1 through 6. And in 1 through 6, the special right triangle is a 45-45-90 triangle. So quickly, zooming into number 2, I'm going to show you what is so special about a 45-45-90 triangle. Say we're given a right triangle with 45 degrees as one angle. Then we can say that the other angle is also 45 degrees. So those two angles are congruent. And the sides A and B with hypotenuse C, A is going to be equivalent to B. So A is congruent to side B. And not only that, there's a ratio for the side lengths, and that ratio is 1:1 to the square root of 2. So knowing that, let's get started with number 1. In number 1, we're looking for the hypotenuse and one of the legs. But remember that the legs are congruent. So that means that B is going to be equal to 2 square root of 2. And now that we know two sides of a right triangle, we can use the Pythagorean theorem to solve for that third side. So we can say 2 square root of 2 squared, one leg squared, plus the other leg squared is going to equal that hypotenuse squared. And in this case, our hypotenuse is A. But notice that 2 square root of 2 squared plus 2 square root of 2 squared can be written as 2 times the 2 square root of 2 squared, since 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. And that's going to be equal to our hypotenuse, which is A, which in this case is the variable A squared. So 2 times 2 times the square root of 2 squared is going to be 2 times 2 squared is 4 times the square root of 2 squared is 2, and that's going to be equal to A squared. 2 times 4 is 8, and 8 times 2 is 16. So 16 is equal to A squared, and when we take the square root of both sides, we'll get that 4 is equal to A. So for our missing sides, A, our hypotenuse, is 4, and B, the other leg of the triangle, is 2 square root of 2. And that's our solution in number 1. In number 2, we're missing both the legs of our triangles, but we can use Pythagorean theorem to solve. And that's because x is equal to y. So for x squared plus y squared equal to our hypotenuse squared, which is 4 squared, we could write that as x squared plus x squared equals 4 squared, which we can write as 2x squared equal to 4 squared, which is 16. Now, I'll divide by 2 to get that x squared is equal to 16 divided by 2, which is 8. So taking the square root of x squared and the square root of 8, I'll get that x is equal to the square root of 8, which we can write as the square root of 4 times 2, and in turn, taking out that perfect square of 4, we'll get 2 square root of 2, since the square root of 4 is 2, and we're still multiplying by the square root of 2. Now we have that x is equal to 2 square root of 2, but note that x is equal to y, so y is also 2 times the square root of 2. And that's our solution in number 2. In number 3, we're missing a leg and the hypotenuse. And remember, for 45-45-90 triangles, the legs are congruent. So y is equal to 3 times the square root of 2 all over 2. And knowing that, a squared plus b squared equals c squared. And if a and b are equivalent, then 2 times a squared is equal to c squared. Or 2 times 3 square root of 2 over 2 squared is going to equal x squared, which is our hypotenuse. And again, that's because 3 square root of 2 over 2 squared plus y, which is also 3 square root of 2 over 2 squared, and a squared plus b squared is equal to c squared, which is x squared. So 2 times 3 square root of 2 over 2 squared We're going to distribute that squared. So that's going to be 3 squared times the square root of 2 squared over 2 squared. And that's going to equal x squared. So 2 times 9 times 2 all over 4 equals x squared. 9 times 2 is 18 divided by 4 is 4.5. And we multiply that by 2, we'll get 9. So 9 is equal to x squared. And taking the square root of both sides, I'll get that 3 is equal to x. So y equals 3 times the square root of 2 over 2, and x is equal to 3 in number 3. In number 4, 45, 45, 90 again. So y is congruent to the other leg. That means that y is equal to 3 square root of 2. Now we can set up our Pythagorean theorem and solve for our hypotenuse, x. Since the legs are equivalent, that means that 2 times the length of one of the legs squared is going to be equal to our hypotenuse squared, which is x squared. So that's going to be 2 times 3 squared times the square root of 2 squared equal to x squared. 2 times 9 times 2 is equal to x squared. 2 times 9 times 2 is 36. So 36 equals x squared, and when I take the square root of both sides, I get that 6 is equal to x. So our hypotenuse is 6. And number 4, y is equal to 3 square root of 2, and x is equal to 6. And number 5, another 45, 45, 90. So y is congruent to x. Therefore, y is equal to x. So as opposed to writing x squared plus y squared equals our hypotenuse 6 squared, we'll write 2 times x squared equals 36, which is 6 squared. Dividing both sides by 2, I get that x squared is equal to 18. And when I take the square root of both sides, I'll get that x is equal to the square root of 18 can be broken up into 9 times 2, which is the square root of 9 times the square root of 2. So I'll say that x is equal to 3 square root of 2. And if x is equal to 3 times the square root of 2 and x is equal to y, then y is also 3 times the square root of 2. So x is 3 times the square root of 2 and y is 3 times the square root of 2. And lastly, in this video, I'll go over number 6, another 45, 45, 90 triangle. And remember, the legs are going to be equivalent. So x, this leg, is equal to the other leg, y. So x squared plus y squared equals the hypotenuse squared. 2 times the square root is 6 squared. So substituting x in for y, I can say 2 times x squared is equal to 2 times the square root of 6 squared, which is going to be 2 squared times the square root of 6 squared. So 2x squared equals 4 times 6. So 2x squared equals 24. And dividing both sides by 2, I'll get that x squared is equal to 12. Now when I take the square root of both sides, x is going to equal, splitting up the square root of 12 into the square root of 4 times 3, since 4 times 3 is equal to 12, I'll get the square root of 4 times the square root of 3. So x is equal to 2 times the square root of 3. And since x is equal to y, x and y are both 2 times the square root of 3. And that is my solution in number 6. Join me in the next video where I'll complete problems 7 through 12. If you haven't already, like, subscribe, and share.